all-time leading field goal kicker from a percentage standpoint. Chris Carr, a rookie from Boise State. He is a flyer on the kick return. So the Raiders will get the ball to start the game. Dawson is into it, a spinning kick that's going to carry short. Taken by an up back. That is Gabriel breaking into open field, and he's across the 35-yard line out to the 37. A good return. Collins leads the Raider offense out. You look at Collins' numbers, 55% completions, a 79.6 quarterback rating. And his offensive line anchored by Adam True at center today because Jake Grove, their very good center, out with an injury. Jordan Lamont, Jordan, their leading rusher, almost 900 yards for the season. He'll get the ball a lot. The rain has stopped at this point. First down, Raiders. Jordan takes on the Browns' front defensive line, and Jason Fisk is the first to hit him as we look now at the Browns on defense. Orpheus Roy having a big season. He's a free agent after this season. He's been one of the best players recently. Signed to a new contract was the best linebacker, Andre Davis. Lee Bodden's getting good grades at cornerback, although he did have those penalties in that stretch drive of the Bengals last week that led to Cincinnati winning the game. But overall, they like Bodden. On a second down play, they go back to Jordan, and the Browns are all over it. Lamont Jordan runs, and he stopped at about the 43-yard line. It's going to bring up third and about five.
And Don, this is exactly what we expect to see today out of the Raiders. Kerry Collins told us yesterday, expect us to feed the ball to Lamont Jordan. The last week, the Cleveland Browns gave up over 180 yards rushing to Cincinnati Bengals. The Raiders know that's going to be a weakness. It's an area they're going to attack. The Browns are very good against the pass, too, so that's another reason to try and pound it up in there with number 34.
34 did not have a good game last week, Lamont Jordan. Now on third and four, Collins pump fakes, throws near side. It comes in low. So the Raiders hear the boos early as their offense goes three and out. And a Raider is shaken up on the play. That's Courtney Anderson, their starting tight end, number 83.
And that's not the start the Raiders were hoping for. North Turner trying to come out and establish Lamont Jordan and then throwing a nice, safe third down pass. Kerry Collins looked like the ball kind of came out of his hand a little bit funny, and Courtney Anderson couldn't make the sliding grab.
And there now is the deep man for the Browns. North cut back anticipating the punt. That'll come from Shane Leckler, one of the best. He booms the ball. Northcutt, that is inside the five, and he backs into his end zone, living dangerously, but now doing some good things as he turns the corner. And Northcutt is on the run across the 40. And so a very questionable catch of the punt. Would have gone in for a touchback with no problem, but Dennis Northcutt thought he had something to go with, and he did.
And Dennis Northcutt is one of those guys. He is a very talented return man, very confident return man, and you can see why. Right there, you'd think it'd be a big mistake, but no, he brings it out of there, gets it back to about the 37, 38-yard line.
Up,
starts off Charlie Fry and this Cleveland Browns offense in good field position.
Charlie and the Browns will go from their 39-yard line. Fry comes in. Completing almost 63% of his passes. Big thing he did last week at Cincinnati. He got his team in the red zone three times, and they scored touchdowns twice. He scored one, and he threw for one. On first down, Drones runs the ball, and not for much. Browns come in with a 23rd ranked offense, and the Raiders have the number 22 defense in the league. As it looks, says he likes the play of his offensive line. Drones, the first 1,000-yard rusher for Cleveland in 20 years. And there is Romeo Crennel. Said he wants his team to continue to play with passion and energy like they did last week. Raiders threaten a blitz now on second and 11. Drones runs, and not much happening in the middle. As we look now at the Raiders on defense. Burgess, Derek Burgess, a defensive end from Mississippi, has 13 sacks already. The middle backer and the lead tackler is Danny Clark. Fabian Washington, North Turner told us he thinks is going to be a standout. He's a rookie from Nebraska, starting at cornerback. He will be targeted, though, today by the Browns because of his inexperience. Maybe right now it's third and nine. First throw of the day for Charlie Fry. Long ball. Man is out there, but he overshoots him, going to Antonio Bryant. Running with him, but really beaten by a couple of sticks was Asamoah, the cornerback, number 21.
And you're going to see some pressure here. You see Jared Cooper coming off the edge, number 40 there, but also good pressure by Derek Burgess early, the sack leader in the NFL. And that's what the Raiders want to do to Charlie Fry. They want to keep him in long third down situations, make him drop back and feel like he has to make a play, try and take advantage of his inexperience.
Now the Browns ready to punt. Kyle Richardson hits the ball. Carr is back, the rookie, backpedaling to the 5-yard line. He has a problem back there, and the Browns, with good special teams coverage, sweep him under. So leading the way downfield for Cleveland was Joshua Cribbs, 16. A 55-yard punt and a minus 1-yard return. Raiders get it for a second time, deep in their own end. Berline back at McAfee Coliseum, Oakland, California. On the exchange of punts, the Raiders lost 39 yards. A tremendous punt downfield by Richardson, and then great punt coverage by the special teams of the Browns. So the Raiders go from inside their five. Trying to get room to work, they go to fullback Zach Crockett as we check the much-awaited B-line from Berline.
Well, when you're talking about today, the Oakland, when they have the ball, we already made it very clear, they want to establish Lamont Jordan. They felt like he wasn't utilized last week, didn't get the ball to him enough. He can catch the ball out of the backfield and run. They got to find a way to get him established. Cleveland, don't take Randy Moss lightly. You can't do it. He's not having the year that you would expect out of him, but if you make a mistake, if you give him a crack, he will make you pay. Know where number 18 is on the field.
He has had a limited good year, 47 catches, but he has been playing with nagging injuries. Raiders go back to Lamont Jordan, who runs the ball and gets it across the 10-yard line. He wasn't happy last week, Steve. Just couldn't get it done against the Jets.
No, he came out. He was very upset with the play calling. He kind of questioned why the Raiders didn't try to establish a run better against what was then the number 29th ranked defense in the league in the New York Jets. It's frustration when a team's 4-9, guys start to complain, they get a little upset. That was just the case of Lamont Jordan feeling that frustration.
Now on third down and 4, Collins takes a drop, big rush on him, and the Browns get him back inside the 5-yard line. Nick Eason, 98, busted through. One of the Browns' problems on defense has been a limited number of sacks. They only had 16 this season before that one. That was huge. It forces the Raiders to punt from their end zone.
Well, you saw the Cleveland Browns came with a blitz, and actually Nick Eason could have been called maybe for a face mask right there on Kerry Collins, but Sean Thompson, number 51, Andre Davis, number 54, came on a blitz, and the Raiders have had a lot of problems this year up front with their offensive line. That's just another example, not adequate pass protection for Kerry Collins.
And here is the second punt by Leckler. This will be returned by Northcutt from the 44. Again, he turns the corner and gets out of bounds at about the 47-yard line of the Raiders. A 51-yard punt and a 9-yard return. And the Browns and Charlie Fry go to work when we come back to Oakland. Raider Nation looking for something good to happen. Right now, the Raider defense is on the field, and Charlie Fry and the Browns offense start with good field position at the Raider 47. Second possession of the day for Fry and the Browns. Short drop, beautifully thrown ball on the hands of Dennis Northcutt. His 30th catch of the year is good for a first down to the 35-yard line. Gain of 13 on the play.
Hey, good solid stand-up throw in the pocket for Charlie Fry. Dennis Northcutt does a super job of turning Fabian Washington off the line. Fabian Washington wanted to jam him, and Dennis Northcutt showed his quicks, and Charlie Fry right on time, right on the money. Big completion to get this offense jump-started.
Steve, as we saw, we had Antonio Bryant on our replay way ahead of the defender. On a deep ball in the first possession, was overthrown, and now Drones turns the corner, and Reuben Drones works the sideline for yet another Browns first down. before a linebacker out of Youngstown State, Tim Johnson, runs him out of bounds, but he does it after a 15-yard gain.
And Reuben Drones is one of the best kept secrets. I guess you can't call him a secret anymore in the NFL. He established himself last year in Denver. Cleveland brought him here. It's a big free agent acquisition. He's a notoriously fast starter. And that jump start right there, that run, popping it outside, picking up 10, 15 yards, that gets him feeling excited and into this ball game.
Yeah, that got him into it in a big way. And now Antonio Bryant to the top of your screen. First down. Browns challenging early in the game. Fry takes a look, dumps it off nicely. They set up the screen. Reuben Drones crashes ahead and gets plus yards down to about the 14-yard line. Good for a gain of 5 or 6 on the play as Danny Clark makes the stop for the Raiders.
Good job by Charlie Fry setting up the screen pass. You know, Derek Burgess, number 56, good pass rusher, thinking he might have a sack. Offensive lineman Cozy Coleman, number 60, gets out there in front of Reuben Drones, and you got a good, solid first down play. And that's the key for the Cleveland Browns. Keep Charlie Fry out of the third and long situations and also capitalize in the red zone.
Which he did 2 or 3 times last week. He's in the red zone now. Here's Drones working his way. A lot of Raiders coming across, shutting it off. Kurt Morrison, a rookie linebacker who grew up in Oakland, played at San Diego State, 52, was on the stop, along with big number 92, Ted Washington.
You talked about the red zone situation with the Cleveland Browns, and look at that. It's over. The run is over. San Diego has done it. Indianapolis goes to 13-1.
I'll tell you, Steve, in all the years we've been doing this, it's rare you'll see a team that doesn't have to win going against a team that does have to win. No matter how good the other team is, where they come up and win the game. The Colts, you can't summon it. They don't have to win. Open backfield, and Fry calls his own number, and big Charlie Fry turns it down inside the 5-yard line, and he has a first down.
And that right there is the element that Charlie Fry brings to the Cleveland Browns. He is a big guy, but man, can he move. He's got great feet. This is a called quarterback draw. He takes a good solid 3-step drop, tucks it. He's got incredible instincts. Picks up 9 yards on the play, get the ball down to inside the 5-yard line. Now, Don, you mentioned 2 out of 3 last week in the red zone. The Browns still are the 32nd ranked team in the red zone in the whole NFL. So, Charlie Fry, they're making improvement. We'll see if they can cash in on this drive.
This is first and goal. Drones hitting hard into the line. And Asamoah, cornerback, came across and got in on the tackle. So the Browns now have it about a yard or so away from the Raider goal line.
Did you see the blow that Reuben Drones delivered right there? Look at this. Watch the explosion from his leg. This is where his power comes from. Lowers that shoulder. Nnamdi Asamoah is sitting there saying, man, this guy delivers a pop. And I'll tell you what, there's everybody around the league that's played against Reuben Drones saying the same thing.
Yeah, he's having a great year. Drones told us when we talked with him that Charlie Fry gives the Browns energy in the huddle. Here is Drones. He hits in, and the Raiders stop him and throw him back. The rookie Morrison on another stop.
Well, maybe Kirk Morrison forgot to get the memo about how strong Reuben Drones is. Let's listen to this pop. You talk about delivering a blow.
Boom.
Yeah, that was a rookie wanting to make a play right there. Heck of a play by Kirk Morrison.
Steve, you're good at this, playing 17 years in the NFL. What's the play call here? What's an option?
Well, you got a lot of options with Charlie Fry with his mobility. I expect something on the edge.
Hitting to the right. And down close, but not in. Charlie Fry signaling touchdown, but the linesman is not. And the nose of the ball is almost at the Raider goal line. Well, the helmets are coming off. Is that Stuart Schweigert, the free safety, is shaken up on the play. He's been a very good player, a second-year player out of Purdue. So Schweigert getting in on the tackle, and he is banged up. So while Stuart Schweigert is attended to, a break in the action on the field with a big decision now for Crennel and the Browns. Fourth and goal from about a yard or less.
Well,
what will the Browns do? We're going to find out when we come back in a moment.
What happened to Stuart Schweigert? Look at this. Watch his head right into Reuben Drones' thigh. That's not a place I want my head. I'll tell you, that hurts. That's what shook up Stuart Swigert.
But Stuart's all right. He ran off, and here is Drones, and he takes it down close. Did he get in?
They're not going to give it to
him. He did not. So on fourth and one, the Browns again try the Raider defense with a run play, and Jared Cooper and Kirk Morrison combine on the step, and Romeo Crennel has to be feeling a major disappointment. Point blank range, and they couldn't get it in. Great defense by the Raiders. They take over the ball at their 1 yard line. We're back to Oakland, California, where the Raiders have stopped the Browns on a fourth and one try for a touchdown. The Raiders take over the ball now. First and 10. How deep their eye back is in the end zone. Just getting it out of here is going to take some doing. To the run. Oh, there's a penalty marker and probably a false start. So the Raiders
34.
Will move back about a foot.
5 yards penalty. In this case, half the distance to the goal. Still first down.
Let's go back and look at that gray goal line stop to see exactly what happened. Good penetration by the Raiders defense, the linebackers. You had Kirk Morrison a bit, but look at Jared Cooper, number 40, right there at the bottom of the screen, grabbing Ruben Drones by the ankles, keeping him from lunging over the top. That is what saved the touchdown. Good effort by Jared Cooper.
Again, now they go to the up deck. The fullback drives ahead, and Crockett gets it to about the 5 yard line. And that'll bring up third down and about six as inside backer Ben Taylor makes the stop for the Browns.
Now, I wouldn't be surprised right now if we saw Norv Turner drop back and try and take a shot here, because they have enough room to get the punt out of the end zone. Trying to throw something underneath. That's what the Cleveland Browns are looking for. So maybe take a shot with Randy Moss up the field for a big play here.
The Raider offense rates 19th in the NFL. The Browns defense 16th. To the run, and they bust it for a first down. Well done by the Raiders. Lamont Jordan is out of the University of Maryland. Shifting runner with power, and he's finally taken down by safety Brian Russell, but after an 11-yard gain.
Oh, that shows you what I know. Watch right here, the right side of the line. Whoa, well, the right side of the line. Ron Stone, the right guard, and Robert Gallagher, the right tackle, do a good job. And then Zach Crockett plowing up in there. Good read by Lamont Jordan to find the cutback lane, stick his head down and pick up 7-8 tough yards, get the Raiders out of that hole.
Good work by the Raiders, and now they've advanced the ball out to their 16-yard line. First down. Collins takes a look near side, throws a fastball, is defended beautifully. Coming over to make the play was Lee Bodden, the undrafted free agent out of Duquesne, who got his hand in front of Doug Gabriel and batted the ball away. Second and 10.
That's a super break on the ball by Lee Bodden. He really has established himself as a strong cornerback in this league. Doug Gabriel just went out and ran what we call a quick hitch route. Lee Bodden read Kerry Collins' drop, went up in there, timed it perfectly, got his arm in there, made a super play. Romeo Crennel really likes this young cornerback.
He's been making plays. And Collins ready to throw again. Out pattern, makes a connection. Brown shut it down short of the first down as Dalen McCutcheon makes the tackle on Doug Gabriel, or on Jerry Porter. 9 yard gain on the play.
And Jerry Porter is the guy that has become the Raiders' go-to guy. Early in the season, the Raiders were really making a strong effort to try and establish Randy Moss, get him going, but he got injured, got the growing problem. Jerry Porter has come back on and really reestablished himself as a big-time receiver in this league, putting up big numbers the last 8 weeks of the season.
That was his 61st catch of the year for Jerry Porter. Third down and one. And they go with the power set, double tight ends. And carrying for a first down is Lamont Jordan. As the Raiders come off the ball very nicely, you know, this drive started inside the Raider 1 yard line.
And this is exactly the same run that Lamont Jordan popped a little bit earlier on third down to get it out of the hole. This is the kind of game that Lamont Jordan wants. He wants to be a factor. He wants to get those tough yards, and he's showing right now that he can handle it.
Lamont Jordan in his fifth year out of Maryland, a power back at 5'11", 230. Now Collins, hands up, it is Jordan again, and again he hits into the Browns defense for plus yards. He gets about 10 before the safety Brian Russell gets him down, and it looks like another Raider first down. So Steve, they've got a game plan that's pretty basic, but it's working well. Run it right at him.
The Raiders have done their homework. You're going to see the left guard Brad Badger, number 70, pulled. It was just a simple counterplay, but the Raiders have done their homework. Last week, we said Rudy Johnson ran for almost 170 yards. Kerry Collins told us, we are going to make them stop the run, see if they can hold up.
Well, right now, the Browns aren't doing it. Raiders running for plus yards every carry. They go to it again. And Jordan hits across the 40 to about the 42-yard line.
You know, Romeo Crennel actually told us in our meeting the other day that, you know, our defense, sure, we've been playing pretty well. We've been keeping teams out of the end zone, but we really do not play good run defense. We play good pass defense, but run defense, very disappointing, and he can't like what he's seeing right now in this game.
We had problems last week. Rudy Johnson had a season-high 169 yards running for the Bengals. Now the flea flicker. Collins takes a look. Browns are all over it. Everybody's covered. So Collins does the only thing left to him, and that's to throw it away. Browns were not fooled. And so I guess all you can do is bail out and take your losses.
I really like the play call, but I'll tell you, you're not going to fool Romeo Crennel defense. You might think you're putting him to sleep. Watch Brian Russell back here in the back. He's back there waiting right there, double covered. They did not bite at all. Good play call, I thought, but it just shows how well disciplined this Romeo Crennel defense is. You can run the ball on him. You might move the ball up and down the field, but you will not get any cheapies. And Todd Grantham, the defensive coordinator, and his troops are very well coached, very well disciplined.
And now they face a 3rd-and-8 play from the Raiders. Collins against a rush, stands in, dumps it over the middle, and misses his connection, attempting it to Lamont Jordan. Then can't hit pass plays. They'll punt again.
Yeah, they just don't seem to have a whole lot of rhythm in the passing game. Kerry Collins, to me, has not looked his normal, real strong self in the pocket so far to this point. He'll get it going eventually, but when you get a chance to step in there and make some short throws early in the game, you want to complete those and try and move the chains, obviously.
And now Northcutt is back awaiting the punt. You'll remember he ran one back 36 yards earlier today. Another well hit ball by Leckler. Northcutt comes up on it. Let's it hop it. It touches him. The ball is down inside the 15-yard line. A Brown got to it. A 45-yard punt. And quite obviously no return. So the Browns get it again in their own end. We're back to Oakland, California. Don Kroeke with Steve Berline. The Browns had the ball. First and goal inside the Raider 5, the last possession. Couldn't get it in. Ran the ball right at the Raiders. Now after a Raider punt, the Browns start again, but this time at their 13-yard line. Charlie Fry, timing throw, puts it on the hands of his tight end, Steve Hyten. He gets about 3. Out to about the 16-yard line.
You know, the Browns on that last punt nearly avoided a disastrous play. This ball, you can't really tell if it hits Dennis Northcutt, but if I'm Dennis Northcutt, or more importantly, if I'm number 50, Isaiah Ekajuba for the Raiders, I'm on that football as hard as I can be. He should have been selling out trying to get that football, because you don't know if Dennis Northcutt touched it or not. I would be all over that thing. Well, whether I would have gotten to it with my great speed, I don't know.
Well, I think
but
you would have.
I at least would have been selling out to try and get to it.
Might have got there late, but you'd have gotten it. But it was Sean Jones, Steve, who made that terrific play. The safety for the Browns, who is Romeo Crennel extols as a special teams player also. He's the strong safety. Log on to NFL.com today and get the latest playoff picture as the games end. It's all on NFL.com and on NFL on AOL. Well, it ended on an unhappy note for the previously undefeated Colts today. They were beaten at Indy Chargers. 16. So those veteran Dolphins are toasting themselves in their unbeaten season again down in Florida. Nick Bonacani's the sommelier. He does the cork popping. Here now is Fry against a big rush. He eludes it. Throws a home run ball. Northcutt is out there. And it's broken up beautifully by Stanford Rout. Number 26, a rookie cornerback from Houston. Tremendous play. And really one by Fry. He missed the connection, but it was close. That's the end of the first quarter with no score. We'll return after this. The Coliseum, the Oakland Raiders and the Cleveland Browns scoreless after one period of play. Out of bounds with the ball at their 16-yard line. Third down arising, third and seven. Terrific defensive play by rookie corner Stanford Rout as the Browns almost hit a bomb on the last play of this first quarter. Here comes the rush. Fry stands in and he comes in high. On a crossing pattern was Frisman Jackson.
Don, you talked about the great play that Stanford Rout made. Well, watch up here at the top of your screen. You're going to see Nnamdi Asamoah. He thinks he's got help over the top. Look at that. Antonio Bryant is running down the sideline wide open. And Nnamdi Asamoah thought he had Stuart Swigert going over the top. Didn't happen. That was a case of Charlie Fry picking the wrong guy.
Now the Browns punt from inside their 10-yard line. Ball hit downfield. Carr coming up on it, and it'll roll to a stop at the 46-yard line of the Raiders. A 38-yard punt and no return. Allen's ready to go when we come back. Run, run, Rudolph. That's in the game plan of the Browns. They've been running Reuben drones a lot. There is Charlie Fry. He's just missed a couple of big throws today. A terrific defensive play, though, by the Raiders rookie Stanford Rout. And now the Raiders will go first and 10 from their 46-yard line. Collins, the 12-year veteran, is off on a handoff and the carry is to about the 49-yard line. Tomorrow on CBS, CY Entertainment Weekly calls Neil Patrick Harris the number one scene stealer on TV this season. Catch a new How I Met Your Mother tomorrow on CBS, America's number one network. It is second down now and seven. Collins. Nicely thrown ball. Good to Porter and good for a first down. Lee Bodden was on the step, but there's an 8-yard gain on the play, and the Raiders have a first down.
You talk about Kerry Collins, and there's Todd Grantham doing a great job with his pass defense. But Kerry Collins told us you got to be patient with the passing game because the Browns, they play in a way that forces you to be patient. And Kerry's come out, you've seen a lot of short throws so far today. When he gets a chance to make a big play, he's got to capitalize on it.
Let's see what Collins can do now on first down and 10. He goes right back to the run. And Lamont Jordan protecting the ball well with both arms on it. Takes on the middle of the Cleveland defense. It was Ray Mickens who finally got him down, but there was a gain of 9. And again, Steve, the Browns run defense, not good.
Yeah, and if Lamont Jordan's going to be able to run the football like this again, you're going to see Brad Badger, number 70, pulling right up the middle, and then Lamont Jordan getting that forward lean, powerful, strong running. If they're running the ball like that, Kerry Collins just to make sure he doesn't mess up throwing interceptions. They're running the ball very well right now.
They sure are. Particularly Jordan. He's run 9 times, 5.5 yards on the average. And here he is taking a pitch back. And he dives ahead and gets down close to the 30-yard line. And we spotted down at about the 31. Lee Bodden on the play again.
And this is a play where they show all the flow going right. Everybody, all the linemen are blocking right. Lamont Jordan's jabs right and goes back left. Very well played by Lee Bodden and Brian Russell on that play. Not to be fooled by the flow of the offensive lineman up front.
And it would appear, Steve, the Browns have lost a little of their gusto after they were stopped on that fourth and goal. The Raiders have really kind of controlled the game since then. But there's still no score. Play fake. Collins looking for the deep ball. He swings it near side, and it's another drop by Lamont Jordan. And Art Lang covering as best he could, but there was no question the running back was open.
And that was a good ball by Kerry Collins. They were trying to make a big play up the field. You can see the ball's right on the money. But Kerry Collins did a super job of realizing, again, the Browns were not fooled by the hard play action. Come off to your check down. Lamont Jordan, that ball was right on the money. He's got to make that catch.
So it brings up second down and 10. Jordan continues to run the ball well, though. He has 10 carries for 52 yards in the game now. And here's another carry. This time they go to Zach Crockett. And he hits inside the 30. Jason Fisk is the lead tackler. It'll bring up third down and long. Third and about 7.
Well, you mentioned, Don, how much that might have taken out of the Cleveland Browns getting stopped short. people sometimes don't understand that when an offense gets shut down with a great goal line stand by the opposing team, it takes the wind out of the whole team. So the whole team feels the effects of a shortcoming or a failure like that. So this defense has got to pick up the tempo a little bit and kind of increase the momentum on their side.
Here's a big down now, third down. Collins with a deep drop and a penalty marker thrown, a pre-snap foul, and a false start on
false
the Raiders.
Offense number 85, 5-yard penalty, still third down.
The playoffs are right around the corner. NFL experts Pete Prisco and Clark Judge break down which teams will make the cut and who will be left out. See if your team is in it at CBSSportsline.com. Well, Seattle fans watching have to be in celebration now as the Seahawks, with another win today, have assured themselves of a first-round bye, and they look to be the number one seed in the National Conference going in.
They look to be the class of the NFC at this point, 11-2. Great job by Mike Holmgren and his staff there.
Here's the ball thrown downfield. It comes in short, and Lee Botten was the closest to it. Jerry Porter was the intended receiver.
A dangerous throw by Kerry Collins. Very good defense again by Lee Botten, with help from Brian Russell, number 27, over the top. But a dangerous throw. You could see Lee Botten knew exactly where Jerry Porter was going on that route. And if that ball would have been a little bit more toward Botten, that thing would have been picked off for sure.
And now a 51-yard field goal attempt by Sebastian Janikowski, who is 0-for-2 on 50-plus tries this season. This one is going to go wide right. So the Raiders drive the ball, but the field goal try is no good. And the Browns take it over when we come back. With Steve Berline, this is Don Kroeke back at Oakland, California. A new setter for the Browns, Jeff Fain, went out with an arm injury. Pucillo is now in to snap the ball to Charlie Fry. Pitch back. Drones. Finds room. And tackle from behind gets him down, but plus yards to the 47-yard line. A gain of about 6 on the play. Tyler Brayton, an outside linebacker, made the stop.
That was a good, solid first down run. And it's going to be interesting to see how Pucillo does at center for Jeff Fain. He's been the three-year starting center, one of the best centers in the league. That's a big loss for this offensive line. And Mike Pucillo's got a lot of weight on his shoulders now because he is the quarterback of that offensive line, making all the calls.
All right, second down and a long three. Charlie Fry goes to a draw play. And the carry is good for a couple of yards to the 49-yard line. Reuben Drones driving again, but he's short of the first down. It'll bring up third and short.
A tremendous run by Reuben Drones just to get back across the line of scrimmage. You see right there, Derek Burgess had a free shot at him. Reuben Drones, I guarantee you, was acting on instinct. He didn't have enough time to see that coming. He felt it, spun off it, was able to come back and pick up 1 yard and avoid a negative play. That's the difference. There's fine line drawn between why teams are good and why they're not good. You got to be able to make plays like that to be successful.
Let's see if they can succeed now on third down and a short two. They run it. Drones responds, and he's going to be very close. The linesmen both come in, though. It looks like where they're coming in is going to be short again. Well, we'll see. Tommy Kelly, number 93, has been a consistent player. He's signaling we stopped him, which will bring up fourth and about a foot.
Well, I'm really impressed with Rob Ryan, the defensive coordinator for the Raiders, and his short yardage defense, short yardage and goal line defense. They're doing a super job against a very physical running back in Reuben Drones and a team that really prides themselves on running the football.
Rob Ryan, of course, was the linebacker coach at Ohio State for 5 years. I think you or I could coach those linebackers, Steve. Go get them, boys.
They pump them out, don't they? Amazing. Rob Ryan probably had something to do with their success out there, too. He's a very respected defensive coordinator. Team is only ranked 25th against the rush this year, but they're making good, solid physical stands so far today.
Rob Ryan, of course, the son of Buddy Ryan, the longtime NFL coach, defensive coach of the Bears in 85, and head coach of the Eagles. Romeo Crennel, as Reuben Drone says about him, he looks like a big teddy bear, but do something wrong, he can lose his cool quick.
Yeah, I asked Reuben directly, I said, does he ever get upset? Can you tell when he's upset? And he said, believe me, you can tell when he's upset.
Now the Browns not wanting to risk field position, even though it's a fourth and very short. We'll go to the punt. Try to gain field position.
And it's the right call. Yeah, people say they're 4-9, go for it. Well, Romeo Crennel is what he is. He's not going to take any unnecessary chances. He's going to trust his defense to make the play and keep him pinned back in their own end.
And the way this game is looking, Steve, looks like first touchdown might win it. Chris Carr, the rookie, fair catches the ball at his 10-yard line. So again, this game of field position, a 40-yard punt, no return. Raiders have it. Nation, here's a hand, a fake, and Collins takes a look deep. Long ball. Browns cover it. It's broken up. Randall Williams, a super fast wide receiver from New Hampshire. And again, it's 28, Lee Bodden. Hey, this guy is becoming a major player defending the pass.
He really is. I mean, he's always in the right position. This is Kerry Collins just deciding, hey, I'm going to take a shot. I'm getting tired of taking these little checkdowns. Let's give our players a chance up the field. And Randall Williams almost made that catch, but a tremendous play again by Lee Bodd. He seems to be always in the right place.
Mike Carey, the referee, was telling us before the game, the defensive backs now are almost always shorter than the wide receivers. And they're so good at waiting the D-backs, but the big guy comes down with the ball and then knocking it away. Quick out to Porter. Not much of a gain. It's going to be at about the 17-yard line, and third down arises. Boy, they're going at Bodden all day, though, Steve. That was at it again.
They are. But you made a good point, though, Don. And it's playing and being successful in the NFL, it's all about technique. And you talk to offensive linemen, you talk to linebackers, running backs, DBs. They're always talking about technique. And that's what Lee Bodden and what Mike Carey was telling us, the referee, these guys have mastered, these smaller DBs have mastered the art of waiting till that ball comes down and then trying to strip it.
And that brings up third down and four. Collins, nice connection. And it's to Jerry Porter, and he is ahead for a first down. Now a penalty marker comes in after Porter goes down.
Yeah, Brian Russell, number 27, came in there a little bit excited. Didn't mean anything by it. He just couldn't stop himself.
Here's Mike Carey getting the official pronouncement from his line judge, who saw it.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Defense, number 27. A blow to the runner after the ball was dead. 15 yards automatic. First down.
Norv Turner finally happy that a penalty goes his way. The Raiders have long been known for their penalty woes. Last week they had 13 penalties. And that really hurt them against the New York Jets.
But there's been years, Steve, where the Raiders have led the league in penalties and won the Super Bowl.
That's true. Yes. That's true.
It's like the Boston Celtics used to lead the NBA in turnovers a lot of years and win the championship. Here is Lamont Jordan trying to turn it upfield. Doesn't get much, and he's ahead to about the 42-yard line. Andre Davis is on the stop.
When you look at what's happened this year, all the big moves the Raiders made, bringing in Lamont Jordan and Randy Moss, it figured to translate into more success offensively, but really, everything's pretty much similar. I mean, there's really no difference. There have not been the noticeable improvement that Norv Turner and this Raiders organization were hoping for. A lot of reasons, a lot of theories as to why it is. It just hasn't happened.
They go to Lamont Jordan. See how he protects the ball, both arms on it. Ben Taylor hits him head on, 58, inside backer for the Browns. But Lamont Jordan now building running numbers. He's run the ball today 12 times for 58 yards.
Yeah, he's really running confident. I think he's on a mission today to really show the kind of style of football that he really wants to be known for, that he thinks his Raiders team can be known for.
Well, as you know, Steve, last week the Browns held Carson Palmer to his worst game passing, 93 yards for the Bengals. He said the Browns played great, but they couldn't stop Ruben Johnson. And now, on a third down run, Lamont Jordan might have broken it. He's... looks like he got the spot. Appears to be a Raider first down.
And at third and five, you're sitting there saying, well, they're going to throw the ball or they're going to run some kind of a draw play. No, the Raiders just said, we're going to see if you can match up and stop us with a good, solid, physical lead run right up the pipe. And once again, it's shown that the Browns can't stand up and meet the challenge.
Lamont Jordan was the number two runner with the Jets his first 4 years in the league, running behind Curtis Martin. Wanted more playing time, came out here, he's getting it. He's now approaching 1,000 yards for the season, just went over 900 earlier today, way over it, up to 950 plus. And here is a handoff again. So North Turner, who was the architect of the great offenses of Troy Aikman and the Cowboys in the Jimmy Johnson Super Bowl years, master of what works, keep pounding it. The old Don Coryell adage, when you find a weakness, beat on it all day.
And I played on those teams in the early 90s with the Cowboys, the first Super Bowl team. And North Turner is without a doubt one of the most creative offensive minds in the game, and very respected around the league for his ability to mix up. But he is committed to the run. It all starts with that.
Collins on second down, swings it out. Nicely thrown and taken in by Lamont Jordan. And he is down to about the 40-yard line of the Browns. It'll bring up third down and about a yard.
Really,
Bodden again, Steve.
It was Bodden making the tackle, but very good patience by Kerry Collins. You can see he's looking up the field for a play. I don't see it. I'm going to find my back and know exactly where he is, give him a good catchable ball. And then Lee Bodden with a good play. I guarantee you he wanted no part of taking on Lamont Jordan up high, though. He wanted to go down at those
number
legs, try and get him on the ground.
Reports as an eligible receiver. Number 71 is eligible.
We got an eligible receiver announced. That is number 71, Corey Hulsey. Normally an offensive guard. They go to the run, and the Browns stack it. And then Zach Crockett, a 240-pound fullback from Florida State, been in the league a long time, 11 years. He spins and looks to have enough for the first down.
Really good second effort here, you can see from Zach Crockett. He is definitely stopped short. Andre Davis right there gets in there, makes a good play, but they don't finish it up, don't get him down on the ground. Zach Crockett, second effort, gets him the touchdown. And that's one of the things that I noticed looking at that film last week against Cincinnati. A lot of times Cleveland was in position to make the tackles. They didn't wrap up and get him down on the ground. That's what Andre Davis did right there.
And because they didn't wrap up last week, Rudy Johnson of the Bengals had 169 yards rushing. Already today, Jordan has 65 yards on 14 carries. And now a penalty marker is thrown, a pre-snap foul, which usually indicates a false start.
False start. Offense number 18. 5-yard penalty.
Randy Moss left early.
And we're still waiting for the first pass of the day to Randy Moss. Haven't seen it yet. Just a little flinch. That's all it takes. And, you know, Randy Moss, you talk about him, and nobody has anything negative to say about him in the organization. They know he's playing hurt this year. He's practicing hard. He's doing everything he could possibly do to be successful. But North Turner did tell us there's no doubt he's not 100%. I don't know what to measure it against because I never coached him before, but he's not able to do the things they were hoping he could do at this point.
Yeah, he's had nagging leg injuries, and here's a throw to Lamont Jordan. He fields it with one hand and crashes down to the Cleveland 35-yard line.
And finishes it by delivering the blow at the end of that play.
9-yard gain.
You watch a very well set up screen. You're going to see number 67, Ron Stone, get out on the screen, as well as Adam True, number 62. And then Lamont Jordan just says, you know what, Chris Crocker, I'm bigger than you. I'm going to run right over you.
9 yards. Run over him, he did. Well, North Turner watched the game tape, saw what Rudy Johnson did, and he's using his guy same way today. Rudy Johnson having the big game for the Bengals against the Browns last week. And here is Collins out pattern on the hands of Jerry Porter, a wide receiver who was a teammate of Randy Moss's at West Virginia. Ray Mickens knocks him out of bounds.
And again, Don, we see another example of the short passing game. Raiders are not known for that, never have been. Al Davis never has been a fan of that kind of ball control passing. But North Turner, I think he's really preached to Kerry Collins today, hey, let's find a way to be efficient.
This team is eligible.
Is not going to give you the big play up the field. Take what's there, be patient.
And we're down now to the 2-minute warning. Still no score on the board here at Oakland, but the Raiders are driving. Third and two when we come back. We're back. Oakland, California. Don Crickey with Steve Berline. The Raiders in this scoreless game now have the ball at the 31-yard line of the Browns. third down and about two where the ball is spotted. Browns had a first and goal in the first quarter and could not get it in. Came away with no points when they missed on a fourth and one try. And they've not been close to points since.
And for Kerry Collins, after starting today very slow, 2 for 9. His first nine passes, he's completed his last five. So it seems like he's finding his rhythm a little bit here.
Reminder that coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report, Greg and his guys will get you caught up on all the scores and stats and highlights in today's NFL action. A day that saw the Colts finally end their unbeaten streak. Chargers ended it for them.
Yeah, a lot of people thought the Chargers might be just the team to do that. They proved them right today.
Third and two. Lamont Jordan driving hard. Browns pushing back. This is going to be close as the linesmen come in. They'll spot the ball at about the 29. Might take a measurement. Orlando Ruff was the lead tackler.
Yeah, this is close enough. They're going to have to measure it. A good job by Todd Grantham's defense making the stop. It's going to be very close, but I don't think there's any doubt. North Turner is going to find. He's going to go for this. Sebastian Janikowski already missed a kick earlier today. He's 19 for 28 on the year. The Raiders are 4-9. If they're short, I have no doubt in my mind that the North Turner would go for this.
And in this drive, Steve, the Raiders were 3 for 3 on third down conversions. This is their fourth third down conversion try in this drive. This will be close. He didn't get it. But as you say, at 4-9, they're both 4-9, both mired in three-game losing streaks.
And North looked out there and said, we're going.
You know the play call. I don't think they'd risk a play fake and a throw. I think they're going to go to Jordan.
Yeah, I think that's what you have to do. You're talking about picking up about a foot.
So Todd Grantham's thinking, the D coordinator for the Browns. So what they do is fake to Jordan and throw to the end zone.
I wouldn't be surprised if I saw that.
I've seen
North Turner do that before. But right here, I think you just power it up in there. You're going against a run defense that has been documented to struggle all season against the run. Pound it up in there.
I think Andre Davis of the Browns told us that the Raiders have speed all over the field. You got to be very careful. Power set. Deep back there. Collins calls his own number and he dives for the first down. So Collins not even risking a handoff to give the Brown defensive front time to dig in. Come out of their 3-point. He takes it himself. And the Raiders drive on late in the first half. Coming up on the Sprint Halftime Report, Greg Gumbel and company will get you caught up on all the scores, stats, and highlights from today's NFL action. Today in the NFL today, Shannon Sharp, when they talked about the league possibly outlawing the long hair, said he's never seen long hair on an injury report. Here is a throw down the field. He felt it was a possible injury problem, the long hair, as a big rush is put on by Andre Davis, forcing an incomplete throw. Yeah. Robert Gallery, the big offensive tackle, was the number two pick out of Iowa 2 years ago.
It definitely is a trend.
The long hair.
It's definitely a trend in the league. You got Zach Crockett right there, Robert Gallery, Lee Bodden.
And it's fully legal to grab it and tackle a guy by.
Fully legal, that's right. And it causes all kinds of health issues. You know, you're talking about whiplash possibilities. You got to get a bigger helmet. The helmet doesn't fit snug. Doug Gabriel right there. It's a legitimate issue, I think, in the NFL.
Well, Ricky Williams of the Dolphins, he cut his because the guy pulled him down from behind by it. Here is Collins throwing to the end zone, and Randy Moss quiet for a while, but the first ball to him today is the first points of the day.
And
a touchdown throw.
You could see it coming, Don. He came off the line right down the middle of the field. Kerry Collins had no doubt where he was looking. They caught the right coverage, and Randy Moss showing that even though he's not 100%, if you sleep on him, if you take him lightly, he's going to make you pay. Kerry Collins knows he can put it up high. That wingspan with Randy Moss on top of that 6'5 body, not many defensive backs can get up there with that football.
Now the point after try by Janikowski. Remember, he missed the 51-yard field goal attempt. He drives the extra point up and through. So the Browns really have not come back from being stopped on that fourth and goal from the one. And the Raiders take a 7-0 lead. He is 48th of the year, good for 28 yards and a touchdown. An excellent drive by the Raiders and Kerry Collins. Now the kickoff. Here's Joshua Cribbs for the Browns. He's got a track. And Cribbs, the much heralded free agent from Kent State, runs it all the way out to midfield. 46-yard return.
Free agent converted quarterback, I might add, out of Kent State.
Yeah, he started 4 years for the Golden Flashes.
Let's go back and look at his touchdown, though. You're going to see a great play action fake by Kerry Collins holding the line by Andre Davis. That wasn't the touchdown there. That was a play earlier. Andre Davis came on a blitz.
That looked like one of mine.
Yeah, I could do that. What the heck?
We're going to see it in a moment. Right now, though, the Browns, are they going to start to go over the top? Earlier today, Fry had some deep men open and just missed them. Open backfield, five wide receivers.
I'm excited to see Charlie Fry work in this two-minute situation.
Pass ball to the far side, makes a connection, and is down to the 43-yard line of the Raiders. And he goes to the aforementioned Joshua Cribbs. 7-yard gain. Game clock down to 56 seconds to play in the first half.
Watch the play action fake by Kerry Collins. Andre Davis, number 54, has to respect the run. And Kerry Collins knows, down the middle, I got my number 18, big Randy Moss. Perfect route, perfect timing, and a big time throw by Kerry Collins for the touchdown. Kerry Collins needed that. Randy Moss needed that just for their confidence.
Now the Browns need some big plays. Here it's Fry dumping it off. Gets the ball to Reuben Drones, and he's got blockers, and Drones is down inside the Raiders 35-yard line. They quickly go into alignment without a huddle.
You see an excited Charlie Fry right there. Plenty of time. Good job spiking the ball.
Charlie's an interesting guy, as you know, Steve. He throws right-handed, but he writes left-handed. He punted at Akron. He punted left-footed. Reminds me of my neighbor, Yogi Berra, back in New Jersey. He talked about people asking about switch hitters. He said greatest switch hitter he ever saw was his Yankee teammate, Mickey Mantle, but he said it was easy for the Mick. He was born amphibious.
He's probably a pretty good swimmer, too, huh?
Right.
Oh, boy.
At the 33-yard line, it's second down and 10. Fry, the rookie quarterback for the Browns, standing at his 38 of the Raiders. He looks. Here comes the heat. He's swept under. Stanford route coming on a cornerback blitz.
And that's an example right there of what I thought we'd see more of from the Raiders. Blitzing Charlie Fry.
Timeout. 33 seconds left to play in the half.
Route. He's not on the screen yet, but he's going to be flashing in from the left side, and you'll see Charlie Fry has absolutely no idea that he's coming and that he's got to get rid of that football. That's what I thought we'd see more of out of the Raiders, to try and exploit Charlie Fry's confusion or inexperience. That was a good example right there.
Well, this is inexperience tested now, an open backfield. They give him time, though. Five wide receivers are running patterns, and Fry throws over the middle, makes the connection inside the 30-yard line to Antonio Bryant. And the game clock down to 20 seconds, 19 seconds left to play.
Well, you got to make a decision here. Are you taking a timeout? You're letting the clock run down. They had another timeout. They could have tried to throw a ball, see if they can get the ball at the field a little bit more. But Romeo Crennel looks like he's going to be satisfied to go with the field goal attempt here.
Why would you not take another shot with that much time?
I don't know.
Two shots.
I don't know. Maybe he's saying subconsciously he doesn't want something bad to happen with his rookie quarterback.
Well,
you know, maybe he might make a bad decision. They might not be able to get back on the ball and stop the clock. Who knows? The bottom line is that Romeo Crennel knows that Phil Dawson can make this field goal right where it is. It's important that we get on the board right now.
Well, Dawson has been tremendous again this year. He has hit 22 of 24 field goal attempts for the Browns. Has had two extra point misses. 17 of 19 in extra points.
This is a 45-yard kick with a soggy field, a little bit of wind blowing. It's not a chip shot or a gimme by any stretch.
Yards it is. There is a swirling wind. The rain has stopped. Very heavy rain earlier today. Snap and set down are good, and the kick. He puts a little draw on it, drives it through, so the Browns get points as the first half ends.
And I did have a revelation, Don. It was fourth down. That's why they kicked it.
Oh, there you go. What a good reason. 7-3 is the count. The Raiders in the lead. Now we're from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS, America's number one network.
that.
Well, Randy Moss with his 47th catch of the year made a big play, and now we'll see if Charlie Fry can bring the Browns from behind. They talked about how he energizes the team, how he gives them confidence. We'll see if he can do it now.
It was important for them to get that field goal before the end of the half, have a few positive plays. They got the good field position by the kickoff return by Joshua Cribbs, gave them a chance to get the ball into field goal range, and then Phil Dawson capitalized right there, get on the scoreboard. It's been a pretty quiet game all the way around so far. Cleveland Browns only had 4 first downs in the first half. 38 yards rushing. I thought they would come out and really try and establish Ruben Drones, but only 38 yards rushing, and then 1 of 6 on third down. That's been the key.
A reverse by the Browns. They give it to Frisman Jackson, and he is taken out of bounds at about the 27-yard line. Let's check now, Steve, the fantasy notebook.
Well, not a whole lot of big-time fantasy numbers here. Talk about the quarterbacks. Well, Kerry Collins got a little bit warmed up after his initial 9 throws, 2 of 9, 80 yards and the big touchdown at the end of the first half. Rushing the ball, Lamont Jordan been doing a super job pounding it up in there. The Cleveland Browns need to get Ruben Drones going. Then the passing game, obviously the big touchdown by Randy Moss, 28 yards and a TD. Get the Raiders going in the positive direction.
First down, Fry comes out throwing, makes a connection on the far side. He goes to his fullback, Terrell Smith, with just his 8th catch of the year. And he's quickly taken down by Jared Cooper, so it'll be interesting now talking to Tom Flores, who coached the Raiders to 2 Super Bowl championships, now a radio broadcaster. He thinks their game plan, when they have the ball, is going to be a lot more of Lamont Jordan. There is Tom Flores.
Another one of my former coaches, my first year in the NFL, 1987. With the Raiders, Tom Flores was the coach. Great man, great football representative, ambassador, whatever you want to call him.
On second down, a play fake. Rolling out is Charlie Fry. He pump fakes and slides to a halt at the 35-yard line. A gain on the play of about 5 yards. It'll bring up 3rd and about 3. The rookie cornerback Fabian Washington touched him down.
And Don, if the Cleveland Browns truly want to get this offense jump started with Charlie Fry as a quarterback, that's the kind of stuff we're going to see. Him getting out on the edge, off the play action, trying to establish that running game, but keep it very simple. Let him use his athletic ability, as we saw Fabian Washington come hobbling off the field there.
The rookie starter at cornerback limping off, so Fabian Washington, who they really like. Top player at Nebraska, an All-American there. It's a problem with his left leg, it would appear. When play resumes, it'll be 3rd down coming up for the Browns, and the ball is positioned at their 34-yard line. Charlie Fry coming on out from Willard, Ohio, about an hour and a half from Cleveland in Northwest Ohio. Charlie says it's a town with not many people, no movie theaters, and had never been to Cleveland, although he's a lifelong Browns fan, until he signed with the Browns.
Absolutely amazing, and he's energized this franchise. And because of his local roots and everything else, LeBron James got the basketball going out there in Cleveland. Charlie Fry can become the local boy done good for the Cleveland Browns.
On 3rd down, Fry looks. There's a throw and a connection and a 1st down. As going high for the ball was Dennis Northcutt. A big play by Northcutt. His 31st catch of the year is good on 3rd down for 13 yards and a Browns 1st down.
I like the throw. Really accurate from Charlie Fry. On the money to Dennis Northcutt. Did a good job getting some separation right there from Ronaldo Hill, number 22, and gave the young quarterback a good spot to put that football. One of the things I want to watch here with Charlie Fry is how accurate is he from the pocket? I know he can throw the ball on the move. I want to see if he can stand in that pocket and deliver strikes.
Well, he's going to come out trying to do it. He's been throwing strikes earlier. This is a dump off as they get the ball to Ruben Drones, and he crashes down inside the 50-yard line to the 47. Tommy Kelly and Ted Washington get him down. Drones is a workman. He never stops. He's going to approach by the end of the season the all-time record for a Browns career carries, or in a season. That's by Jim Brown some years ago. In a 12-game season, Jim Brown rushed 305 times. Ruben Drones has now rushed over 270 times.
And Ruben does not get tired. He gets stronger as the game goes along. He's a relentless effort runner.
They play thick to Jones. Here's a throw now, and up the middle, the ball goes to Ruben Drones. And Tommy Kelly is quickly there to snuff it out. 45-yard line, third down, and it looks like three will be coming up for the Browns.
And who was Ruben Drones' best game against when he got his first shot at being a starting running back last year against the Oakland Raiders? Right here in this very same stadium, he came out and lit up the Oakland Raiders for big, big numbers. He seems to find playing in the confines of this stadium very comfortable.
Charlie Fry has thrown 14 times, has completed 10 for 73 yards. Now the heat is on, and throwing on the run, he gets it down the sideline, and they rule out of bounds. Receiver was not in. Northcutt, his target, he likes Northcutt. Browns coming in with the 23rd ranked offense in the NFL against the Raiders' 22nd ranked defense. And the punter has to come out as they fail to convert. And there is the very fast return man, the rookie from Boise State for the Raiders, Chris Carr. Richardson hits the ball hard, and it caroms into the end zone. Richardson does not have a good net punting average, just 33.7 for the season. We're back to Oakland, McAfee Coliseum. The Raiders holding to a 7-3 lead. That's how they stood at the half. Now with their first possession of the second half. Collins has hit 8 of 16 throws, 80 yards and a touchdown. And Lamont Jordan is again the game plan.
And the Raiders' last drive of the first half was by far their most impressive. You see Kerry Collins being patient, taking a swing pass to Lamont Jordan, then right here, good setup on the screen pass, waiting for the opportunity to make a big play, and here it comes. Finish it off, strike right down the middle to Randy Moss. Big time throw and catch to get the Raiders on the scoreboard.
And he was, Steve, as you know, 6 for 8 throwing the ball in that touchdown drive. Oh, yeah. Throw near side, and the Browns are reading Jordan. He's getting the ball everywhere they can get in his hands.
And again, more of the same, though, Don, right there, getting the ball to Lamont Jordan, just like we showed in that little package right there. You got to take what's there against his defense. And when they give you the chance to make a play, you've got to make them pay for it. But you can't force the football. And we talked in the open about Kerry Collins. He had only one interception the first 6 games of the year. And then from games 7 through 12, 9 interceptions. So that was the problem. He was trying to force the football too much.
That's what causes it, huh?
That's what causes it.
Forcing the ball. Well, on 3rd down and 7, he's going to throw the ball. Here come the pass rushers. He stands in, dumps it off. And the Browns defense can't make the stop. They had Lamont Jordan and lost him. But he did get to the 30-yard line, and he gets a first down.
And again, we talked earlier about the tackling of the Cleveland Browns. Lamont Jordan, he's making these guys pay if they don't wrap him up and take him to the ground. You can see he's just running through people, catching the ball out of the backfield, up the middle, on the outside. He's doing it all, and that's exactly the role he wants to play for the Raiders. He wants to be featured in the running game and the passing game. He said, get the ball in my hands. We can move the football.
He's been getting a lot of touches, 16 carries for 67 yards, running it. 4 carries for 25, catching it. Here's a throw and a catch, and did Randy Moss come down with it? They're waving it off. It hit the ground.
Yeah, that ball hit the ground, but almost an unbelievable circus catch by Randy Moss.
He was selling hard.
He was, but really a bad throw by Kerry Collins. And, you know, I've seen the Kerry Collins make this throw in his sleep. Randy Moss was wide open coming across the middle. The ball was a little bit high and behind him. Only Randy Moss could almost make that play. But you see, Randy Moss is really wide open across the middle of the field. Kerry Collins should be able to make that throw in his sleep.
Second down and 10. Jordan. Now the Browns are sending people at him no matter where anybody else is running on the field, because it is quite apparent, and was long ago, that North Turner is basing his whole game plan around 34, and with success.
And rightfully so. And you look at the Browns defense, what's the difference between last year and this year? Not much across the board, except look at this right here. They're the 10th best defense in the NFL as far as giving up points. They're finding a way to keep teams out of the end zone. Very, very good red zone defense. That's the bottom line. It's the most important stat in football. Points allowed and points scored.
Yeah, those final numbers are what it's all about.
It's what it comes down to.
Here's another penalty marker thrown before the snap.
False start. Offense number 18.
Mike Carey says that Randy Moss gets his second false start called against him. Both these teams struggle with run defense. Raiders are 28th against the run, Browns 27th.
You saw right there at the bottom of the screen, I got caught up watching Chris Crocker come in, and he was trying to time up his blitz. He got his feet tangled up with Kennard Lang on the right side, and they both ended up tripping before the ball was even snapped. Today, four penalties for the Raiders.
Well, there's a big difference.
Big improvement.
They really tightened things up today, the Raiders. Now on third down and 17. Gary Collins, pump fake. Yeah. Lobs the ball out there. It's taken in by Moss, and they rule he was out of bounds when he came down with the ball. Again, they go at Lee Bodden, but he makes the play. So the Raiders will have to punt.
And Lee Bodden again was in great position to see Randy Moss on the sideline. Lee Bodden knows exactly where his responsibility is. He's right there. Look, it's hard to tell from that angle, but it could have been his toe on the line. I think that's what the referee probably saw out there.
He is so deceptively fast, Randy Moss. I remember Brian Billick saying when he coached for the Vikings, he said he thought he was dogging it when he came in, and all of a sudden he's 15 yards behind people.
Exactly right. He's one of those few rare athletes that can blow right past you and not look like he's too fast.
And Leckler gets a huge punt. A big Raider roll, a 55-yard punt and no return, and the Browns get it back.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 40. A diamond is forever. What would you do for love this Christmas? And by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
The Browns with the ball, the Raiders with the lead, 7-3. Third quarter, first and 10, Cleveland. Fry on the run. Morrison, the linebacker, comes up and gets him with a good open field tackle. Tuesday, January 17th on CBS, Tom Cavanaugh stars in the new series Love Monkey, the show that's all about what friends, music, and life are all about. Love Monkey, coming to CBS January 17th, America's number one network, and there he is himself, the Love Monkey.
Who would have thought he'd be at our game today, the Love Monkey himself, here in person.
Some bad looking monkey. Second down and about 9. Man alive, a trick play. That was intended to be, and Charlie Fry does good work. Was he trying to hand it off there, Steve, or pull it back?
I don't know. It looked to me like maybe he was trying to pull it out and he caught Ruben Drones' arm. We'll see right here. He comes back. He's trying to drop it in there on the draw play to Ruben Drones. The ball just slipped out of his hand. And Charlie Fry is one of the few quarterbacks with the athletic ability in the comfort zone. When that ball, things break down, he's got that ball in his hands. He knows how to run with it, got it back to the line of scrimmage.
Well, they say that Fry, young as he is, has the confidence of the people in the huddle with him. He'll need it now. Raider defense digging in on a third down and 10.
And this is where you can really try and take advantage of a young quarterback.
Fry stands in. Lets a long ball go. And it's broken up at the 38-yard line. He was shooting again at Dennis Northcutt. And Stanford route breaks up another one.
And just a little bit too late. You know, one of the knocks on Charlie Fry coming out of Akron was that his arm strength was a little bit of a question mark. I agree with that. I don't think he's got a really strong arm. I think he's got a strong enough arm. But if he waits too long to throw a deep ball, it's not going to get out there far enough.
Well, that was well short. Now the punt takes a Browns roll inside the 45-yard line and down to the 42-yard line of the Raiders. So a 36-yard punt and no return, and the Raiders go back on offense in a moment. Lamont Jordan has been the really the pillar of the Raider offense today. 17 rushes for 65 yards. Four receptions for 25, so he's had 21 touches for 90 yards. And a couple of drops in there on pass plays. And now they go right back to him. Here's a penalty marker thrown in by the umpire, firing at an offensive lineman who's on his knees pleading. Could be a hold on the offense.
It's going to be on Adam True, but.
Holding offense number 62.
That's it.
10-yard penalty is still first down.
The Bengals heading towards the playoffs, playing the Lions today. Greg Gumbel has more on that.
All right, Don. Yeah, it's all one-sided as the Bengals are adding to the Lions' misery. Rudy Johnson, 4 yards and a touchdown. A win clinches the AFC North for the Bengals. 31-7, about 9.5 to play in the third quarter, guys.
Thank you, Greg. Somebody was telling me, Steve, that at Lions games, at Red Wings games, at Detroit Pistons games, even when on the road, people start chanting Fire Millen.
Not surprising. They're not happy out there in Detroit.
We're mad is under the gun in Detroit.
Yeah. Former teammate of mine, I hate to see it happen, but boy, they got a pretty ugly situation going out there. Speaking of ugly, that was not a real pretty pass right there. Again, Kerry Collins, just he's got the big arm, he's got the ability to make those throws. He's got Jerry Porter one-on-one on the outside, and North Turner says, you know what, Kerry, I know you can make that throw. We got to have it.
And that is Marcus Tuiasosopo, the fifth-year quarterback out of the University of Washington, who started last week, was sacked 6 times by the Jets. As the Raiders have virtually no offense, here's a great fake by Collins, a throw down the middle, it's on target, down to the 45-yard line of the Browns. It is Randall Williams from New Hampshire with a 24-yard gain.
And that's more like the Kerry Collins that North Turner wants to see, that I'm used to seeing. Look at him set up strong in the pocket, the good play action, and boom, that ball comes out of there on the money. To Randall Williams, good, strong, decisive throw by Kerry Collins right there.
Well, you mentioned, Steve, that Collins is a former teammate of yours with Carolina, and he's always been known as a guy who can throw the deep ball well.
Yep.
That could be coming again soon.
Well, with the people they got out there, he should be throwing up there once in a while.
Collins now goes to a screen pass play, and the Browns defended perfectly. In fact, knock it down for a substantial loss. A 6-yard loss on the play, and Lee Bodden was the lead tackler.
And there,
go ahead, see, I was going to say the NFL today.
Yeah, you got it.
Manning versus Manning. Not the ones you'd expect, though.
Yep. But Shannon says maybe another Manning, Ricky Manning Jr. from Carolina. I don't know about that. And then the AFC wildcard picks. Dan says it's going to be Jacksonville and Pittsburgh. For the NFC, Shannon says Atlanta and Dallas. We will see how good these guys are, their prognostications.
Might be on Dream Street with Atlanta. They've got some work to do.
Yeah, they do.
Nicely dumped off. It's picked off by the Browns. And it is Lee Bodden. So Kerry Collins has a ball bounce off his receiver, Jerry Porter, and Lee Bodden is all over it. And this first turnover is a big one. Browns have it. We're back. The first turnover of the game went to the Browns as Kerry Collins' throw bouncing off his receiver, and Lee Bodden is on it for the Browns. And now they go to Reuben Grimes, and he finds a crack near side and gets it down close to the 41.
And let's go back and look. This really is not Kerry Collins' fault. He actually puts the ball right on the money at Jerry Porter, who was trying to see where the lane was. After catching that football, he forgot to do the most important thing, that's secure the football, and Lee Bodden in the right place at the right time. Jerry Porter knows that's his fault. He kind of hung out Kerry Collins on that one, and I know he feels probably worse than anybody about it.
And a Raider is down. It looks like it might be outside backer Tyler Brayton, who is being attended to at midfield. So the clock is stopped with 3:50 to play in the third quarter while Tyler is attended to with the Raiders in the lead. Tyler Brayton got up and ran off. He took a hellacious block from the lead blocker for the Browns, fullback Terrell Smith. Now the Browns go first and 10. Fry, using his mobility, takes a look downfield and throws across the middle and makes a connection down. And now that ball is turned over and they're going to rule it. He's apparently down. Antonio Bryant had it and lost it. As a Raider was streaking the other way with the ball.
Yep. Ball should have been caught by Antonio Bryant there. Not to be. Never had control of it.
Romeo Crennel told us that he gave Charlie Fry the keys to the car, as he called it, starting him. But he didn't wreck it, so we're giving him the keys again this week.
That's right. He's showing he can handle it, is what he said. And until he shows he can't, he'll be the man.
Reuben Jones running hard on second and 10, gets to the 35.
We're going to look back at that block on the play that Tyler Brayton got hurt. Here he is right here on the bottom of your screen. You're going to see Terrell Smith come in, and Tyler Brayton doesn't even see him. Look at that. Boom. Head right in the rib cage. And that number 42, Terrell Smith, for the Cleveland Browns is 240 pounds on the move with a helmet right in the rib cage. Tyler Brayton's still feeling that one, and he'll be feeling it for a while.
But he is up and apparently ready to come back in. Third down now, a big one. Fry stands in, steps up. Here comes the rush, and again he buys time with his good feet. Throws downfield and makes a connection. Antonio Bryant caught the ball at the 13-yard line and is out of bounds at the 11.
Well, that is what Charlie Fry does best, right
Charlie
there.
Fries.
When things, yeah, the Charlie's Fries right there. When things break down, look at this. Antonio Bryant not even really in the play, coming from the backside of the field. Charlie Fry does a super job of getting that ball to him on the money, and it looks like he got both feet in.
So the Browns challenging now for possibly a go-ahead score. Pitch back. Lee Suggs runs the ball and runs it well down to the 6-yard line. They go with fresh legs and get plus yards. Stanford route saved a touchdown for the Raiders.
And that was the case right there where the Cleveland Browns, Romeo Crennel, good job of trying to get the play called quickly. Look at 1-2. Let's see if that second foot is in. Looks like it was in, but they told Charlie Fry to get up to the line and run a play quickly because, as we all know, if the offensive team runs another play, they cannot go back and rule that play. They didn't want to give North Turner time to make a decision if he wanted to challenge that play.
Second down and 4 for the first down. Fry again rolling out, throw to the end zone, and it's off the hands of his receiver. Again going to Antonio Bryant. And that stops the clock with 1:58 to play in the third quarter.
And this is just a great defensive play by Nnamdi Asamoah, number 21. Watch this. He sees it. He knows Antonio Bryant's going to be getting that football. He accelerates, closes the gap, and makes a play on the ball. Great play by the first-round draft choice out of Cal Berkeley last year.
Asamoah's parents are from Nigeria. He grew up in Los Angeles, played high school football there. And he makes a big play, and now it's third down. Third and 4 for a first down. Third and 7 for a touchdown. Fry throws. It's knocked away. Ball was on the hands of Antonio Bryant, and then knocked away. Looked like Chris Carr was in defending.
Really good play by Chris Carr. He's kind of an emergency defensive back, they told us yesterday. Mainly a return man, but does a super job of staying with Antonio Bryant. Yeah, there was a little bit of contact, but really good, solid effort, and one of those plays where you could call it either way, but give the kid credit. That was a really good defensive play.
And now Dawson, who hit from 45 yards in the first half with a 24-yard attempt. He drives it through. Dawson, 24 for 26 on field goals for the season. And he brings the Browns to within one, so they capitalize on the Raider turnover and get 3 points.
Help your overall percentage, in my opinion. Call me crazy.
No, I think you're all over it.
Yes, I am.
Phil Dawson ready to kick off now. He's accounted for all the Browns scoring with the 2 field goals. And there is Carr, who broke up what looked like it was going to be a scoring throw.
Yep.
rookie from Boise State.
The Raiders do really have to be satisfied holding the Browns to a field goal, but they know offensively 7 points is probably not going to cut it. They're going to need to get some points on the board here before it's all said and done.
And Chris Carr can do what the Raiders have loved most over the years. He can run fast. There he goes. But the Browns, with continuing good special teams coverage, as we ask the question on the NFL.com interactive fan poll, who is the NFL's coach?
Every one of them has done a spectacular job getting their team to where they're at.
Now, where the Raiders are at is a one-point lead. Collins throws down the field, and he's almost picked again. A weird-looking throw. And his intended receiver really kind of knocked it down. That was the fullback, Zach Crockett, it looks like, coming at the ball. Tipped at the line.
Yeah, that ball was tipped, and Kerry Collins very fortunate not to have that ball intercepted.
Matt Stewart got it.
Matt Stewart got his left arm up there and deflected that ball.
He's been a valuable acquisition, a fifth-year linebacker from Columbus out of Vanderbilt. And he just puts both arms on the ball and says, catch me if you can, and they cannot until he gets 9 more yards.
Wow, he hit that hole like he'd been waiting a long time to get a carry. It said, it's my turn finally to run this football. I'm going to rock it. I'm going to explode right at the middle. Great job. I mean, he got that football. There was no doubt in his mind, no hesitation where he was going with it. Straight up the gut. Good, solid run by Lamont Jordan.
And his number, Steve, now to 18 carries for 74 yards. Third and one. Pitch back to Jordan. First down and a lot more as he finally run out of bounds inside the Browns 40-yard line down to the 36. Chris Crocker ran him out. But Jordan comes up limping. 25-yard gain.
And this is the same play the Raiders ran a little bit earlier in the game where all the flow is going to the right. You're going to see all the linemen pulling this way, and then Lamont Jordan goes back to his left. You can see right there, Matt Stewart, number 55, got sucked in by the flow of the offensive lineman, and it gave Lamont Jordan the edge to get outside. He kind of pulls up lame here at the end. That's not a good sign because there was no contact.
Yeah, it's tough to see where he got hurt. Now a ball on the field, and Collins falls on it. And he is quickly touched down by Matt Stewart, but there is a loss on the play of 8 yards. It'll be second down and 18.
Just terrible timing for something like this. Kerry Collins comes out, and it's going to be just a straight handoff up the middle to Zach Crockett. But the ball, we saw it happen earlier with Charlie Fry. It is a little bit wet out there, and that ball sometimes comes up a little slippery, and it just squirted right out of Kerry Collins' hands.
There is Lamont Jordan, who's having a tremendous day. 19 rushes for 100 yards and 4 catches for 25 more. Collins is sacked. Linebacker blitz, and it's Sean Thompson with his 4th sack of the season. He came apparently unblocked.
He was like a bullet
alive,
right out of a cannon.
Kaboom. Ooh. A 7-yard loss on the play. Now a word from your local station. Interesting sequence. Don Cricky with Steve Berline. The Raiders get a 26-yard gain from Jordan on first down to the Cleveland 35. Then a loss of 8. Then a loss of 7. And now it's 3rd and 25 coming up. After the first down run. Here is Collins. Throws to nowhere. Wow. No penalty markers down. A couple of people were down in the secondary.
I don't know what was going on there, but that looked like Dalen McCutcheon, Jerry Porter, and Ray Mickens were just having a little wrestling match on the ground there. Watch this. Jerry Porter, number 84. Look at boom, boom. And they're all three of them go down, and Doug Gabriel's wide open on the sideline.
Sometimes that's interference.
Yeah, it could be interference, but, I mean, Jerry Porter almost looked like he was trying to block Dalen McCutcheon initially.
Northcutt is back. Shane Lepper, who's been to the Pro Bowl as a punter, takes his time. Browns had a big rush on. And it takes a big Raider roll. Another beautifully done punt by Leckler down to the 11-yard line. 39-yard punt and no return again. Meanwhile, on the field, the rookie Charlie Fry has hit 11 of 20 throws for 95 yards. He's not turned the ball over. Only turnover of the game, an interception of Kerry Collins, and now Drones trying to go wide left as they run a stretch play. Here's the marker thrown in by the referee, Kerry. Mike Kerry fires in a from behind the play.
Holding, offense number 82 is declined.
Steve Heiden, the tight end.
Yeah, what a super play by Danny Clark, number 55, the middle linebacker, just shooting the gap. Too fast for anybody to get up on him, and took a gamble trying to cut the angle for Ruben Drones to the sideline. Makes the play, tremendous play, makes it very fruitless to accept the penalty. You already got a 2-yard loss. Good solid defensive play.
And again, the pressure's on the rookie Charlie Fry. Second down coming up, second and 12. His team down by a point.
Down by a point, he's got to be smart here, though.
Throw and a catch and a first down. Antonio Bryant, who was under some fire during the week, Romeo Crennella, kind of a veiled criticism, said he's had a good year, Bryant, but there have been some drops.
Look at this shot that Charlie Fry takes from Danny Clark, shooting the gap again, right in the rib cage. That, you know what, Charlie Fry showed me something right there. He threw a strike with Danny Clark coming right at him, right up the gut. Charlie Fry knew he was going to get hit. He stood in there and threw a strike. And I'll tell you, you want to talk about earning respect from your teammates. You stand in the pocket strong like that, take a hit, throw a strike, get back up. These big boys up front, your teammates notice that stuff.
Well, it was on a, they needed 12 and he got 13. And now the Browns, before running out of time, all the time out. Play clock was almost out.
Hey, bro, you see that?
What?
Did you see that?
Oh, no way!
And the Cleveland Browns come out of the huddle after he made a big throw, paid the price for hanging in, took a shot in the ribs. But he's ready to go with a first down. The Raiders leading the game 7-6. Raiders trying to come after him. Play fake. Right. Throws it in the flat. Terrell Smith gets it in a good open field tackle. The fullback Terrell Smith gets ahead for some yards, about four. Time permitting on the Subway postgame show, Greg and the gang will get you caught up on all the scores, stats, and highlights from today's NFL action. But Charlie Fry says it's important to give off good vibes in the huddle. You played 17 years, Steve. Hopefully you gave those off.
I hope so.
I'm sure you did.
I hope so. It's important. That's right. Quarterback has to inspire confidence and enthusiasm in his teammates.
Fry again with good feet. Lets a long ball go. He's got a man there. What a play. It's downfield to Antonio Bryant. One of the best throws of his career, it has to be, because it was absolutely perfect under pressure. A 33-yard strike, and it had to be perfect to get it in.
Oh, and it was tight coverage. Nnamdi Asamoah was right there. Charlie Fry, very decisive on that throw. He made a decision. He stuck it on the money. He couldn't put the ball up in the air anymore because there was help coming over the top. And number 30, Stuart Schweigert, he had to get the ball to him quick. What a great throw. Two great throws in a row by Charlie Fry.
And still a long way to go in this game. 12:44 to play in it. Raiders by a point. Ball on the field and the Raiders get it. Terdell Sands comes up with the ball. So I don't know, we'll watch on the replay how the handoff was missed.
I don't know if Ruben Drones was expecting that football to be stuck in there. They were faking a reverse with number 86, Dennis Northcutt. And Ruben Drones doesn't really look like he's expecting that football. He thought Charlie Fry was going to pull the football out and give it to Dennis Northcutt on the reverse. There was some kind of a miscommunication, and that's what Ruben Drones is saying right now. I thought he said reverse. And there's so much terminology when you call a play, when you call a fake run action with a reverse off of it. The quarterback has to be very clear in the huddle in saying, hey, this is going to be the reverse. Make sure that everybody knows there's no question what play is going to be run.
Yeah, there's no question also, Steve, that he was looking upfield. He wasn't looking at the ball at
no,
all.
No, he wasn't. He didn't think he was getting the ball.
Brown's first turnover. The Raiders have turned it over once. And they go back to Lamont Jordan. Good to see Lamont back in there and limping off after a 26-yard run earlier, but now he's back and running well. Middle backers Taylor and Andre Davis get him down.
You know, Don, one of the things I always did when I was in the huddle, I would tell them if there was a special play coming, I'd grab the guy and I'd say, hey, guys, listen up. We're going to run the reverse here. All right, everybody understand? Then you call the play so they know beforehand it's going to be a reverse. That's something that I don't know whether Charlie Fry did it or not, but it's a lesson learned if he did not.
Maybe doing it from now on. Here's second down and six coming up. Collins gets time and runs out of it in a hurry. As Alvin McKinley, who was, I think, doubtful to play because of an injury, is in there sacking the quarterback for a 7-yard loss.
Yeah, it's his fourth sack of the year. He's the sack leader for the Cleveland Browns. Just does a Barry Sims, the left tackle, number 65. He has been very average in his play, shall we say, lately. He got beat a few times last week against the New York Jets. That time right there, he had no idea how to stop Alvin McKinley, and it's a free, easy sack on Kerry Collins.
Browns defense has three sacks of the quarterback today. In the previous 12 games this year, they had only 16.
5 yards, third down.
And last in the league, I believe.
That is last in the league. And the Raiders, they're showing right now why they're 4-19. They get the momentum back. You know, Charlie Fry makes some great plays for the Cleveland Browns. Cleveland has all the momentum. The Raiders come with a big turnover. And what have they done? They've gone backwards on two plays. They take a sack. They get a penalty. That's how you end up at 4-9.
Bad place to end up. They're both 4-9, both mired in three-game losing streaks on third and long. Collins stands in, throws it up the middle. Lamont Jordan has it. And he's taken down at the 49-yard line.
And he's hurting again.
He's short of a first down. It brings up fourth and about four. Rodney Poole, a rookie from Oklahoma, was the tackler for Cleveland.
Yeah, we haven't gotten a report exactly on what the injury is for Lamont Jordan, but it appeared they were working on his ankle or his Achilles somewhere down there when he came up. That's something worth watching for sure, because the Raiders need him on the field.
Now Leckler to punt again for Oakland. Booms it. Northcutt comes up on it, lets it hop down, and do the Raiders keep it out? Very close to, yeah, they rule it cuts the end line, the goal line. And so it is a touchback, and it'll come out to the Browns 20. So the Browns hit some big pass plays their last possession, then turned it over. Now down by one, they get the ball back in the fourth quarter. The rain falling again now in Northern California. Deluge earlier today. It's been a good condition for the most part during the game. But now Charlie Fry and his Browns down by one, needing to drive the ball down the field. Still a lot of time left. Five releases, makes a connection to his tight end for a gain of about three or four. Steve Heiden makes the catch.
And the Cleveland Browns offense, they've had opportunities today. Down in the red zone early in the game, they get stuffed by a great goal line stand by the Raiders. And it's been more the same all day. They've made plays when they've had opportunities middle of the field, but when they get down close, they don't cash in. The big turnover on the last drive. Got a little momentum going with two big pass plays from Charlie Fry, but they give the ball right back to the Raiders. They've been not able to sustain or capitalize.
Fry takes a look, throws it near side, and the ball is caught somehow. A terrific play by Terrell Smith, making a fingertip grab in the rain, and he gets ahead for a first down for the Browns.
You know, I love talking to Terrell Smith.
He loves the game.
He loves to play football. He doesn't get a chance to show his athletic ability very often, but look at this. 240 pounds is hurdling somebody, and he's excited to say, yeah, you didn't think I could do that, did you? None of you guys thought I could get over that guy.
He's the guy who talked about the poison command that Charlie Fry shows in the huddle. Now the rain still falling, but letting up a little. That first down, and the Raiders are all over it. The Bengals and the Lions. And it's an all Bengals today so far. Let's find out more from Greg. Thank you, Greg. I tell you, Marvin Lewis waited a long time to get a head coaching job. He's been tremendous.
He sure has. And the players love playing for him.
They do. Here's a throw and a catch. This is Antonio Bryant. In the rain and amidst the hits, he drives ahead for a Browns, well, close to a first down. He'll be a yard short. For over 140 million views out of Mississippi State in the second year. Raider fans, they don't get a lot of rain here. Doesn't seem to bother them. And the field in surprisingly good condition. It was, well, they had it covered, but there were some pools of water when they took the tarp off. And the grounds crew went to work and did a great job.
Yeah, I've been really impressed. I really thought it was going to be a sloppy, sloshy type of field the way it was raining all night. But it's held up very well.
Third down for the Browns. They need 1 yard. Fry lets it go. That's got to be an intercepted. No, is there a pass interference call? There is not. It's ruled an interception. Ronaldo Hill picks it off. Looked like he was bumping the receiver. But the official right on it says no. It was clean all the way. And the Browns again turn it over.
You know what? I really like the play call by Maurice Carthon. But give Rob Ryan and the defensive staff of the Oakland Raiders credit. They were not fooled on this play. Third and short. Good hard play action. Ronaldo Hill in perfect position. I don't think he ever saw the ball. He just felt it was coming, turned back, and the ball hit him right in the chest. Heck of a play, finding that football and pulling it and keeping control of it. Yeah, you deserve that souvenir, Ronaldo Hill. Great play, big play for the Raiders. We'll see if the Raiders can capitalize. Only their fourth interception of the year. That is by far the lowest number in the NFL. Huge play for the Raiders.
So they go for the deep ball on third and one and get burned. Big play by Ronaldo Hill. Lamont Jordan runs yet again. He's now carried the ball 21 times today for 109 yards. Fisk and McKinley are on the stop, but time, Steve, now becoming a factor.
It is. We're down to 7.5 minutes. Lamont Jordan is still favoring that right foot ankle area. Don't know exactly what it is, but he's getting up hobbling every time after he carries the football.
Charlie Fry works the sideline now, waiting to get back in there. He's 17 for 27, 166 yards. That was his first interception of the day.
And that was not a bad decision. He took a chance. The Raiders made a great play.
Here's a throw in the flat for a Raider first down. Nicely done by Collins as he gets the ball to Doug Gabriel with his 27th catch of the year, number 85. 8 yard gain. And we're told that Lamont Jordan had an injury to his right big toe.
And he just went over 1,000 yards on the season. Quite an accomplishment. Third Raider since 1986 to go over 1,000 yards. That right big toe, he must have had it bent back funny, or and it's not funny, but it hurts. I know that much. I've had it done before. And for a running back, that's a huge issue.
But he's in there, ready to go to work. Lamont Jordan, bad toe and all, bangs ahead. 22 carries, 116 yards. He got 7 on that one.
You know what I'm sensing here, Don, is that this guy right here, Lamont Jordan, is really relishing the opportunity to be featured here and to show what he can do, to show his teammates, to show this organization, this whole stadium, that, hey, I'm a tough guy, I'm a workhorse, I can fight through injury and pain, and I'm still going to pound it up in there. You see the comparison to Ruben Drones. It's definitely been Lamont Jordan's day. Ruben Drones has not been able to get on track yet.
And the Raiders are 28th against the run on their defensive unit, but they go back to Jordan, and he dives ahead. The linesman comes in. Looks like he might spot it just short of a first down. It will bring up third down and short. As the Raiders have the ball inside the Cleveland 45-yard line.
And North Turner more than satisfied to just pound it up in there. He's got the one-point lead. So pound it up in there. They're able to gain yards on first, second down, keep it in third and desirable. They don't have to score. They'd much rather eat the clock up, keep running the ball, and maybe kick a field goal, get a touchdown at the end of it. But don't leave Cleveland much time on that clock.
He just saw D coordinator Todd Grantham of the Browns. He knows what's coming. It's Jordan, Jordan, and more Jordan. And here's Jordan again. He brings it. Lamont Jordan gets a standing ovation from the Raider fans as he takes it inside the 30 on a 15-yard run.
And I'll tell you, these Raider fans, they love this type of football. They really appreciate good, hard, physical football. Lamont Jordan saying, I like to play that game too. Look at that, right at the pipe. Give all of their offensive linemen credit. You got Adam True, Ron Stone, Robert Gallery, Brad Badger, Barry Sims. They're running the ball very, very well, and it starts with them getting good push off the line of scrimmage, giving Lamont Jordan a chance to get up into that line.
And it's pretty much a basic zone blocking. Hit what's in front of you. Jordan is stopped this time with 4:10 left to play. A look at the current AFC playoff picture. The Indianapolis Colts unbeaten season ending today. San Diego defeating them at Indianapolis. Denver winning yesterday at Buffalo goes to 11-3. The Bengals heading to 11-3. They're winning big at Detroit. And New England, maybe the team to watch.
New England's the team to watch, but I'll tell you, Denver and Cincinnati are both playing for that home playoff game. The bye, first round bye, huge significance the last 2 weeks of the season between those two teams.
And as the Bengals are in the process of closing out a win against the Lions, the Bengals will win their division. Here is Collins. He gets an awful lot of time, and now he runs out of it and throws the ball away. Was he out of the tackle box? Mike Carey, the referee, was all over it. Rules that he was. It was not intentional grounding.
And that's exactly right. Mike Carey was
all over. There's
no foul for intentional grounding. The quarterback was out of the pocket. The ball got back to the line of scrimmage. They're down.
Always in control, that Mike Carey. Very, very clear thinker, very decisive. Kerry Collins had plenty of time to make this throw, and Randy Moss was over the middle of the field. Kerry Collins, he's pointing to him saying, you know, there's a linebacker in the way, move a little bit. You'll see Randy Moss, he's wide open, but right in Kerry Collins' line, you can't see it. Andre Davis, number 54, was standing there. Kerry Collins wanted Randy Moss to move one way or the other.
Here's Collins throwing a fastball. It's on the field, incomplete. Three of the Browns' 9 losses have been by a field goal. They lost this to Detroit, Houston, and last week to Cincinnati. And today they're down by 1 as the Raiders try to hang on.
Yeah, and this is a team that everybody in the NFL believes is really on their way up. They just haven't quite learned how to close out games, how to win these close games. But they've been in, Don, as you said, every one of their games has gone down to the wire.
Well, we saw them really play the Colts. Unbelievably tough at Indianapolis early in the season. Here's a long field goal try. It is blocked. So Janikowski, who has struggled all season, has one blocked, a low kick, and the Browns take over with 3:15 left to play, and the Browns down by a point.
And that wasn't even close. That hit somebody in the nose, I think.
Don't go away. This one's going down to the last play, it looks like.
We're not back.
Alvin McKinley credited with the field goal block for the Browns, and they take over the ball down by 1 to the Raiders. Fry takes a look, makes a throw and a connection to Lee Suggs. As we'll watch the field goal try.
And we'll watch the ball. You're going to see right here in the middle of the screen, Alvin McKinley and Orpheus Roy are going to break through, get some good penetration. The big paws go up in the air. In the left arm of Alvin McKinley, number 97. You'll see 99, Orpheus Roy and Alvin McKinley go up. But it's Alvin McKinley's left arm that makes the big block and keeps Cleveland in a position where a field goal can actually win the ball game for him.
But also of a major concern, the last two possessions, turnovers by the Browns. Here's a throw and an incomplete pass. It'll be third down and about 6. Tonight on CBS, it's 60 Minutes, a secret American plane used. Is it a one? It's all tonight on CBS, America's number one network.
And there's Rob Ryan. He knows that his defense has to make a stand here. They've played very well all day. They've given up a few plays, but they've made the big stands when they've needed to keep Cleveland from taking control of this game.
A huge play for Fry over the middle, makes a connection. It's a first down for Cleveland as Frisman Jackson, a former quarterback himself at Western Illinois, makes a grab, turns the defender, and lunges for a 9-yard gain.
Big 9-yard completion. I like the decisiveness in Charlie Fry. Puts the ball in the money. Frisman Jackson did a great job on Jared Cooper, number 40, giving his body as a target to Charlie Fry, and then makes a big catch, stretches out for the first down.
Now they go to the run, and there's nothing much happening for Reuben Drones as the Raiders continue to stuff the gaps with big defensive linemen. Reuben Drones today, 17 carries and just 45 yards, while his counterpart, Lamont Jordan of the Raiders, has run 25 times for 133 yards. And we are down now to the 2-minute warning with 1:57 left to play. With Steve Berline, this is Don Crickey back at Oakland. The Browns trailing the Raiders 7-6. 1:57 left to play. The rookie quarterback for Cleveland, Charlie Fry, with a 2nd and 10 coming up from midfield. Rose hits his guy. It's going to be short of the first down as the receiver is ruled down at the 43-yard line. Reuben Drones coming out of the backfield caught the ball.
And I don't know, that was close to being a no down by contact. Reuben Drones didn't think he was touched, but a good catch, good effort on his part. Charlie Fry, he's doing the right thing. They need 13 more yards to get into makeable field goal range. You got a minute and a half. Don't force the football.
Down to 1:23 to play. Third down. Fry is sacked back at the 47-yard line, and now a penalty marker's fired in. Charlie Fry's indicating the Raiders got him out of the face mask.
Oh, and that just is.
Here's Mike Carey. He knows.
On the tackle. Personal foul. Major face mask.
Oh.
Defense, number 56. Man. From the dead ball spot, 15 yards, automatic.
Oh,
first down.
That is just absolutely. The Raiders had tremendous pressure on Charlie Fry. They had the sack. There were 3 or 4 guys there, and Derek Burgess somehow got his hand in there and must have been pretty obvious with it because they called not only
he got it big time.
Yeah, man, that's just, you got to be disciplined. I mean, he's the NFL sack leader, but you just cannot reach up and grab the quarterback's face mask, especially in this situation.
Fry runs the ball, and that looked like a bungled handoff as Fry gets it to the 38-yard line. So he had 17 from the line of scrimmage for a possible field goal try. From here, it'd be a 55-yarder.
Yeah, they got to get, in these conditions, you obviously have to get it a little bit closer than normal. The 34-yard line is where they're saying comfortably he needs to be. But I would, if I were Charlie Fry, I would say you need to get down to the 30-yard line.
This gives us a chance to tell you that the executive producers of the NFL.
You know, I know.
Now the ball is inside the 40-yard line. 2nd down and 11 coming up. Browns looking to work their way into field goal range. Their kicker, Phil Dawson, is 2 for 2 today. All their points have come off his right foot. The Raiders dig in. They forced 2 Brown turnovers here in the 4th quarter.
And I expect some heat to be coming here on one of these next couple plays.
Heat's coming. Fry with good feet moves out. And now throws the ball and makes a connection. They rule it a catch at the 28-yard line.
And that is a huge
Frisman
play.
Jackson makes another play, Steve, for 11.
Yeah, Frisman Jackson, 2 big catches. He's been quiet all day, but 2 big catches on this drive. Charlie Fry showing again what it is that makes him unique. It's not standing in the pocket that makes him unique. It's getting out on the move when things break down and him making that catch.
I tell you, Frisman Jackson's been a major force in this game as it wears on, making some big plays. And Charlie Fry continues to work methodically and very cool under fire. Norv Turner looking at his defense out there as Charlie Fry has hit 21 of 32 passes for 198 yards.
They may be thinking about reviewing this from up top just to make sure, but it looks like Frisman Jackson's feet were in bounds. The only thing that it's a mute point right now. I think he was inbound.
Right now, with the ball is positioned, it would be about a 45-yard field goal try. Big thing though, Steve, as the Raiders dig in to go after the ball is for Fry to protect it.
Yeah, the Raiders know now that they are in Phil Dawson's range, and you're going to see blitzing coming here. They've got to knock the Cleveland Browns back out of field goal range.
Drones runs the ball, and very well, as Ruben Drones is down to the 18-yard line. And the Raiders are going to call a timeout here.
Try and preserve some time.
With 54 seconds left to play, a good call, a 9-yard gain for Cleveland.
And there you saw Kirk Morrison had a chance to make the one-on-one tackle, but pretty hard to make a tackle on a running back with the quality as Ruben Drones in the open field one-on-one. He's going to make most guys miss.
Well, we talked earlier, Steve, about how in the NFL there's an adage that field goals don't beat touchdowns, but maybe one will today.
Maybe one will. Three field goals do beat one touchdown. It'll be the third field goal for the Browns. I'm a little surprised. Rob Ryan, they did blitz a little. They brought one guy off the edge, but I figured it'd be more of an all-out type of blitz to try and really create some kind of pressure in the backfield, try and knock the Cleveland Browns back out. I don't think they brought enough pressure there to really create problems for the Cleveland Browns.
Both these teams mired in a three-game losing streaks. The rookie Charlie Fry in the shotgun. Conservative play now. They go to the run. And a very little gain. They needed only two. And now, was there a turnover?
But that's
Raiders,
what the Raiders
they've got
saying.
The ball. Raiders signaling they have the ball. Let's see what the official says. Was he down by contact? There's been no official signal. Raiders are in celebration. Now the officials are huddling, trying to keep the players off. Has been no change of possession signal. This is huge.
It is huge. And whatever way they rule this, it's going to have a tremendous advantage because it's got to be conclusive in the replay as to whether or not it was a fumble. Let's look. The knee's down. You can't see the ball at that angle.
The guess here, Steve, is it will not be ruled a fumble.
The ruling on the play is a fumble recovered by Oakland.
Oh. It is indeed a fumble.
Now this thing will be
that one replay. It didn't look like it. It will be replayed.
Yeah, they will review it. They will try and get it right. The two angles that we saw did not even see. You couldn't even see the ball out. So that remains to be seen.
Here we are. I mean, where is the?
You can't see that. Oh yeah, he's down.
He's down.
He's down. Yeah, that's going to be overturned. No doubt about it. He was down for a good couple seconds before that ball came out.
What a game. Two struggling teams battling every inch of the way.
You know, I would not want to be in Mike Carey's shoes right now, the referee, when he comes back and has to tell this crowd that it was not a fumble. I don't know how well these Oakland Raiders fans will take that.
Well, the Browns, they looked up at the matrix. They're staying on the field with their offense. He's down.
The angle from behind that we saw before, which showed the ball coming out, makes it very clear that he was down before that ball was pulled out.
Browns fumble the ball to the Raiders, and now here's Mike Carey.
After reviewing the play, the runner had complete control with his knee down before it came out. We have a reversal. We third down on the 19-yard line.
You thought, Steve, it had to be reversed, and it was. So the Browns live again for the moment.
It's the right call. There's no doubt about it. You can't see it from this angle, but the angle from behind shows that Ruben, he's down right there, and the other angle shows clearly that after he's down, that ball does not come out till well after. See, it squirted out right there, and a great job by the Raiders of trying.
Third and one on the 19. And we have a timeout open.
The Terdell Sands did a
third down coming up. And Charlie Fry, in his wisdom, takes a knee and downs the ball.
I think Romeo Crennel's seen enough of the ball squirting out of the quarterback's hands.
It's a wet day.
In the backfield with a little bit of moisture out there right now. That ball squirts out of there. Can't have it in this situation.
Field.
And this will be the last play. The Browns can let the clock run down to basically 1 or 2 seconds if they want to.
It is fourth down, so they won't call it stop the clock early in case of a bad snap. They can't. They've got to kick it. Ball is well positioned. Steelers. Joe Avezzano, special teams coach for the Raiders.
Now the Raiders do have some big boys inside also that can get up and block a kick. They've got Tommy Kelly, who stands 6'5". They've got Terdell Sands, who still stands at 6'7". Ted Washington, big Ted Washington, 6'5" and at least 365 pounds. So there's a lot of beef in there that the Raiders are going to try and get up and block this field goal.
And it is. This will be a 38-yard field goal attempt. Kyle Richardson is the holder. This is it. This is the game. Kick is on the way, and it's down the middle. Phil Dawson with his third field goal of the day wins it for the Cleveland Browns on the final play. So without a touchdown on the day, they go on the road and beat the Raiders in Oakland. A third field goal. Looked like a bad snap. A great hole by Richardson. He got the ball back up.
A super job by Kyle Richardson, because that was a low snap behind him a little bit. You'll see he does a good job of handling it and getting it down. And give Phil Dawson credit, too. He stuck with it.
Now for Steve Berline. This is Don Kroeke saying so long from McAfee Coliseum, where the final score is the Browns 9 and the Raiders 7. Tonight on CBS, get started with 6.